today is the 27th of September 2016 and we're here on the third floor at Roma Street, the coach station here, and they have various companies here including TransLink, or it is now known as New South Wales TrainLink, and we'll be getting a bus down to Casino and board our train there for Sydney. Oh, well, we just arrived a few minutes ago here in Casino, and the row of buses are here ready to load eventually to go to different destinations on the Gold Coast and Brisbane and other places around the region, and we'll just get a quick look at the train, and after a while be cleaned and ready to board. That's just a bit of a view of the train, the XPT, and it's only been in a few minutes. It's around about 10 to 7 at night on, of course, the 27th, and what will happen here is they're cleaning the cars, and they will no doubt call people to board the train wearing car A, which is up here, the first car on the front, the sleeping car. Sydney end of the train, in other words, the driver's already there, and it's a 5-car train with 2 power cars. Quite a busy station at Casino here, but as I was saying before, coming in by bus from places like Byron Bay and the Gold Coast, Robina, Brisbane, and boarding this train and heading off to Sydney. We're just pulling out of Casino, and we had a couple of chunky beef pies for sort of a dinner, and a bit of orange juice, so pretty plain sort of fare, let's say. But here we are leaving the station right now, and just getting underway. We've got a forward facing cabin in the center of the car. Still hear a bit of squeaking. I don't know, this has been a problem with these trains, a bit of squeak squeak, you know. Goodness, I don't know. Anyway, I guess we'll just make more of a movie tomorrow morning in the daylight when we're coming in towards Sydney. Here's my wife, who always lights up every room, as the saying goes. It's just like that. Anyway, I hope you enjoy this trip, dear.
Yeah, I hope so too.
And we're running on time, and hopefully we'll be okay into Sydney tomorrow morning. It's about 7 o'clock.
But this is September.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. Oh, yeah. I can't even.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome aboard. Casino Sydney XPT service. My name's Dino.
Oh, Dino, I know him.
Service supervisors to Gibraltar City, where there will be a crew change and then through to Sydney. Oh, thank gosh, you went to the car. It's currently open and serving evening meals and light refreshments. And further announcements will be made by the senior manager attendant regarding the buffet service throughout your journey.
Here we are at Gosford pretty early in the morning. It's about 6. And actually, we'll be coming back here a bit later this morning. There's a little police station there, and I'd say we're nearly on time, and here we are. Just a bit of a view, and it's only early yet, but it's a nice little view over what is called Brisbane water, and we've just departed Gosford. And as I said, we'll be back in a few hours' time, literally. We've arrived in Hornsby, and there's a train across the platform there. It's actually in the next platform. It's going down the North Shore. And we're about to leave here, but I'll just have a general look around, and we can see my missus. Look, she's taking pictures. There you go, enjoying the good life on the trains. What do you think, love? It's good. Are we blessed?
Yes, we are very blessed.
Blessed and fortunate and lucky.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yeah. To have this sort of life that you can travel around on the trains and enjoy the countryside and see people. We're going to go meet some of our friends in the coming days. We're leaving Hornsby. Very, very busy place, Hornsby. It's a junction for the North Shore line, as we can see here. The tracks will go off. Off to the left, very sharply, there they go, underneath that bridge. And they go down through North Sydney and over to the city by the Harbour Bridge, in other words. Lots of apartments here. Coming into Sydney Terminal, there's the old mortuary station where the funeral trains used to go from many years ago. It's a historic building now. And a bus storage area here. And we're just arriving in platform number 3 very shortly, and over on platform 2 will be the Melbourne XPT, and there's getting a platform 1. Where in the old days the Southern Aurora used to go from.
I can't see this one. This was carriage A, isn't it?
Yes.
And the next plane, I don't know.
Next train is, I don't know, look on the next.
Where is it? I can't even find the A for this one.
There. Brisbane Roma Slip Card Service. Oh,
yes,
this one,
it?
XPP train.
XPP.
Sydney
to Central. Here we are. And there's the...
That's going, it's here now.
Yeah.
But 28. No, but is it F? Carriage
F,
F. But
yeah.
This was not FT,
it
was A.
Yeah, that's correct.
Oh. Over here
that's
now.
Correct. It's yeah, right. It's there now. It's right there. We're here now.
You don't worry about it. Maybe they...
We've arrived at Central. Quite a lineup of trains. There's two XPTs over there. There's an Explorer there, probably going to Canberra. And here's the train we've come on off from Casino. And there's the Melbourne train. And I'm not sure where that XPT is. I think Central West. That might be going to Dubbo. So they're lined up in every direction here, the trains. For an Australian scene, it's quite a lot of trains. So there we go. Oh, so we're out in the main concourse, Central, and we've got a gold Opal card for Lottie, which is good, and $15 on it, and get a few days running around on that, and a bit of a general look around before we do other things. And we get the train actually at 8:15 to go to Gosford. Plenty of time, about an hour, nearly an hour. I don't care what anyone calls them, they're trams, as far as I can see. all over advertising. Oh, I hate that. Gee, they're well crowded. What they call the light rail train heading for Dulwich Hill. Right, we got into the double-deck interurban car and with purple seats now, and we're heading off to Gosford. And some passengers, I don't know, they just can't help themselves, can they? I won't say any more. And she's going backwards. I don't know why she's going backwards. She's going to sit over there in a minute. So well, I don't sit backwards.
It doesn't worry.
No, it does to me. So anyway,
yeah, but I didn't know. I thought it was going to be that way.
Yeah, she thought it was going to go driving up to the main concourse. But anyway, anyway, we'll just take little bits and pieces along the way. Just departing from platform 10 at Central. Right on time at 8:15 a.m. on Wednesday the 28th of September 2016.
It's time
9:35. 9:35, yeah. We're due at Gosford 9:35. This suburban train coming in. And another one. Tangara. Slowly going out of Sydney Yard. Trains everywhere, actually. On empty cars going down here. The paralleling suburban train here as well. Newtown, a new station at Newtown, actually. Get little bits and pieces as we go on the way here. We've passed through Peterson, we're heading towards Summerhill, and we pass over the light rail line very shortly. I don't know whether we've seen any. Not, but anyway. Lewisham, so we're heading towards it now. And look. It passed over. Yes, I saw a tram, would you believe it? It'll be in the film, I don't think. It's out the corner of my eye. We're approaching Summerhill, where I lived many, many years ago, I'm talking the 1970s. Lots of people lined up to get on trains to go to the city. Missus over here having a look at the window. She's tired, she wants to go to sleep. And that would be Burwood, I think. It was Burwood. And we're about to come to Strathfield very shortly. The bus. Another all over advertising bus, isn't it? Lovely.
Next stop on this train will be Strathfield, followed by Eastwood.
The interesting thing is, even though this is a long distance commuter train, let's say, to Newcastle, people can get on it to go here to Strathfield and places like Eastwood, Epping, and Hornsby.
Next stop, Strathfield.
Yeah, we know. We're here now. Very important junction station here, Strathfield. Lots and lots and lots, hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of people. Just amazing numbers of people here, I think. Not all in Thai to get on this train, but boarding trains here frequently. just passing through Hawkesbury River Station and soon be on the bridge. Crossing over the Hawkesbury River. Goes to Hamilton actually, and then there'll be a shuttle bus into Newcastle. Just get a quick look at that and go upstairs. HR double again to Ribbon.
Parents, please keep children away from the platform edge.
Trains can sleep through this station at any time. Smoking is not allowed at this station or off. Smoking is not allowed at this station or off. Pretty sure this is Enelong Beach, your minor beach in Enelong Beach here near Coyle. And Elise has brought us down here and looks down towards Palm Beach. Very nice area, actually. And they're walking along up in there, so we're heading up to have a cup of coffee or lunch. Coffee, I think, at this time of day, 11:15.
There's no waves.
No. It's very low here. You can see that people walking in the water on the low. Sort of low tide, I suppose you'd call it. Seagulls and ducks and sort of thing around. Get all the boats. Gosford, and very nice along here, actually. So Lottie and Elisa are along here as well. And nice sunny day. It's very good. Well, there's a bit of a view of Forrester's Beach. And a couple of our lovely ladies looking at the view. And we've still got a little bit of a walk up the hill to get another view. There we go. There's some people walking down these metal stairs. If it sounds like I'm a little bit out of breath, you've got to believe it. I blame this 100% on Elise. But anyway, it's a very interesting experience.
That's the tower that we went.
That's the tower we went, that's right. And there's the stairs we just climbed, all right, guys? People running up here. You got people running. Look, there's people running. There must be a snake on the path back there. Is that right? That's the only reason I'd run. Oh, you can't tell me these people are that fit. That's not possible. Oh, guys, this is a sand path, and only 1.5 kilometers from the phone tower, but it feels like about 10 miles, man. I'm just going to come to the end of this walk, and there seems to be a bit of emergency or something here because fire trucks and maybe rescue trucks or whatever. Let's find out what's going on. Pretty amazing. We're more or less looking towards Gosford, I think, but we've gone as far as we're going to go, and I don't know what's going on here, but try and find out, I guess. We're at Gosford Station, there's a little bit of rain, it's Thursday the 29th, and I won't make much here, just other than the fact that we're heading off into Strathfield, Summerhill, and then Chatswood, and Bankstown, and eventually Canley Vale tonight, so busy day today. Strathfield now, just getting off this interurban train and it's going to Central Station in Sydney. And we get a local down to Summerhill. This is a city circle train, but not stopping at Summerhill. It stops at Ashfield, Redfern, Central and so forth. Next train we'll come into this platform 7, we will get it. Very brief video here. This is Summerhill, the main street. I lived here back in the 1970s. We're here to meet a couple of our friends, and we'll have a cup of coffee in the meantime and meet up with them. Anyway, we're at Rockdale Plaza for a bit of a lunch. There's my friend, and there's my wife. Oh, they're both hiding. Goodness me, what have they done wrong? Are they breaking the law in some way? And anyway, just a shopping centre plaza, there's nothing spectacular to it, but that's having a bit of lunch and catching up with a friend. Chatswood, and here's a 343 going into Chatswood Station. Soon we're getting on the M40 bus and going to Wynyard. Well, we're at Bankstown Sports Club, and it's got some railway themes here in the decor, including this Greenfield Station, unusual name, isn't it? But there you go. You can have dinner in a dining car. Greenfield Station Bistro, there you go. In the pretend railway carriage at the club, just have dinner. And, well, it was alright, it was an experience. What do you want?
You
Right, anyway, this is sort of like a bit of a view around the club. You've got railway themes here, carriages. They're not real carriages, but they're not bad. They're not a bad little. There's some photos, not knowing about it, representation, I'll put it that way. Even a level crossing. Bells and wine. You know, it's a bit of a railway theme, it's alright. Now, my American friend Shuddy, get your heart out. This is a club, and it's like Vegas, you know. Slot machines, one end to the other. Anyway, it's a pretty good, spacious club. Plenty of different varieties of food and entertainment, whatever here. Really what it amounts to. There's a thousand ways to lose your money. Anyway, we're here at Stanwell Tops and we're going to get a magnificent view here. And a lot of tourists here, mostly Japanese, but that's fine. They're getting to see something spectacular here. And we're also going to look down the view, down the beach and down that towards the Seacliff Bridge. And we're going to go down there and have a look at that any minute now. Another view on the beach. It's fantastic. This is where Hargraves flew his plane. Around about the same time as the Wright brothers. There's a lot of dispute about this, but I think Hargraves might have been earlier than the Wright brothers and not bothered making a fuss about it, therefore not being historically the first person to fly a powered aircraft. So we get a view of the. We'll look around, we see Johnny, we see, as I said, a couple hundred tourists looking down the coast. There we go, look. Train down there, look. Too late. He's gone into the tunnel now.
Where is he now?
He's in the tunnel. It'll probably take about half a minute and he'll be out.
We're waiting on a train to come out of here, out here.
And that's Stanwell Park and Township.
I think we can. There is a four car Oscar. There he is.
Or a H6.
Comes round. Yeah. Whoa. Yeah, it's coming. Yeah. Okay, well, we're about to go onto the Seacliff Bridge, and today, I forgot to mention this, today's the 30th of September, and here's the spectacular country coming up. You can see up into the cliffs there, then back down on the road. And we go around, and I'll get a view across the ocean in a moment too. Beautiful along here. Seacliff Bridge, here we go. And we get some more views, we might walk back halfway, I think. It's a good day for that, here we go, it's fantastic. Absolutely spectacular along here. Must have cost millions and millions to build the bridge. There we are, looking up there. You can look up there, you can just see the top of the cliffs. There we go.
The old road
is. The old road is over there, and it was built in the 1880s, wasn't it? They said.
Yeah. A lot of landslides.
Yeah.
A lot of people there
today. Yeah, a lot of people coming along, they walk along here to get the view, you know. Park your car and you walk back. So there's of the bridge.
It was meant to fly, you know.
And I just getting little views here and there of this bridge. And, one last quick turn and we'll have traffic coming across here. And looking along the ocean side of it. So that's looking out the Tasman Sea. And there's an old theatre, Anita's Theatre. Is it still operating?
Looks like it is, yeah.
It's still called Anita's Theatre, so it must be very old. Could be 30s or 40s or something.
Yeah.
Yeah. Just on a freeway, it's B65 freeway heading. We're going to bypass the main centre of Wollongong. Just important to say here, for those who are hanging out, obviously, to see the nose cap diesels at Goulburn, which is I've titled the movie after. It will be a bit later. This today we're doing as far as Braidwood, like down through Nowra and Braidwood, and then tomorrow, the 1st of October, we'll be heading up to Goulburn, where I will obviously film those diesels, and we keep hoping, I was going to say fingers crossed, but when we pray and hope that everything's going to be okay for the weather.
Thank you.
And Trains Magazine is sending a tour out to attend that, so it should be interesting. And I understand a lot of locomotives are coming across today from parks for the event. So I just thought I'd let people know that it's a bit further along on the movie, and hope you do enjoy whatever you see. We're just coming past Wombo's coming up. I think the railway station is up here.
Yeah.
And you can see a little bit. There's that little building. See the wooden fawn colour? That's it. There's the station. A station that's almost on the beach.
It is.
Wombo. Really quick view here. This is Bombardieri railway station. There's actually a train in the platform. And I really only got to get a quick look because we're running a bit late in what we wanted to do today. So I'm just going to basically get back in the car and head towards Braidwood. This is the little town. Dulla. Quick look at the little boat harbour here. And still having a couple of showers along the way, but everybody taking a picture. Just on here in the car. We're in Batemans Bay, and there's a couple of interesting looking little local buses. One there. Surfside, it says, Long Beach 761. There's another one below them. And there's just see a ferry in the background, the bridge. And anyway, just have a quick look down and just look along one of the streets, the main street building, I suppose. A town of maybe about 20,000 people here.